Welcome back to the Proace build. As you can see, we got some walls, got some lighting, got some carpet. Let's get into it and show you how we did it. Let's get cutting. I'm cutting the factory bulkhead, make a little sort of cocoon around the driving area. This will help with a bit of sound when you're driving, although the van is pretty quiet anyway. As you can see, there's a gap where the window was. So I'm making a quick template. I'm going to cut out some 1mm metal off the old window guards and I'm going to bond that in place. Getting rid of all the sharp edges, then I'm going to use some van liner, get it all upholstered. Now to get this floor in permanently, it's going to be screwed to the framework that was built. You can see that in the part 2 video. A little slot in the floor to pull the main battery cables through for the domestic batteries. This is kind of a placeholder of where the sort of galley area is going to be. Now starting on the van liner fabric, putting this down with a contact adhesive, spray it onto the panels first, then onto the fabric and work from the top down. That makes it easier because you can use a bit of gravity and kind of stretch it into place. You can get this line on eBay, comes in different colours. It's about £5 a metre and the rolls are 2 metres wide. I think it was about 4 metres for the van, so not too much, but I'm not doing the full walls like in some vans. What I'm doing here is just cutting along the edge, and then what I'll do is I'll take these and I'll just push it into the gap where the floor is. We've got hardwood flooring going on top of this anyway, so that'll cover any bad edges. On some of the trims, and you can just use a bit of clutch and brake cleaner on a rag, spray it on the rag, and that should just wipe it off. What I'm going to do here is make this shelf that's going to be in this panel, this wall panel. So first of all, I need to figure out where these beams are. So they're going to be the main fixing points. And there's one here as well. So that's going to be
be fixed in along there and there, but they're quite easy to get to, so at the bottom. So I'll put some tape, and then I'm going to put the panel in place, and I'm going to measure up from these points to the beam, and I can do the same here. So I've got these little marks where those tapes were. Measure up, put a point, do that along, draw a line, then that should be where the beam is, and then I can figure out my shelf from there.
These are some pre-made ply panels that I made in episode 2, so have a look at that if you want to see how they were made. But yeah, just cutting out the shelves, little shelf unit for your like phone and stuff, and there's going to be a little charging point in there, and they're going to be lit with some LED strip lights. I'm going to paint them white, as you can see here. Now to make the little shelving units, made these out of 9mm ply. Probably could have gone 6mm to be honest, because they were a bit tight when I actually got them in. Just made these shelves. Now we've got some little fascia plates to go in to here, and then the 12-volt socket. These are some extra ones I got made on the old van, so we're just going to put these in. So I ended up gluing and screwing the shelves to the 6mm panels. Now I'm just screwing them back into the van permanently. Countersunk these screw heads so they can be filled afterwards and then painted over, so it all looks seamless. Now I'm going to get onto the wiring once these are all set in place. So I like to use these little wacko clips. These are knockoffs, but they're perfectly good. So I've got one big ground going to my, I've got an LED light in here and a 12 volt socket. So I tend to run just one ground to here and then use one of these to then split off the grounds to each separate item. Just twizzle the end a little bit. Secure in there. Then to connect the other wires to each item, I use these little cable connectors. These have got heat shrinks on them. You're supposed to use a heat gun, but I've only got a lighter, I don't have my heat gun here. So you just slot each end in and crimp them up. Made a quick test rig. These are AAs, which are 1.5 volts each. Just see there. So we get 8 of these in a little rack. You can get these things on eBay, and then you can just test. Like as you go along, you can just test your wiring. That's what I do anyway. So just touch them all together, and we have light.